Side steps. Use those arms. If you get tired, you're gonna put your arms down first. Bigger arms, bigger cardio, bigger moves. So you're either stepping out or you're pulling. Arms forward. There's four, three, two, arms down. Here we go. Four, three, punch it out. March it out, grab your booty band. We're gonna move those hips, ready? Here we go. Other side.
Thursday, I don't care about you. It's Friday, I'm in love.
Switch. Eight, Monday, seven, six, month. Five, four, Tuesday, three, two, switch it out.
Thursday doesn't even start. It's Friday.
Four, three, two, 40 side.
Saturday, wait.
Switch. Four, three, two, and switch. Two counts.
Tuesday, Wednesday, hard to tell. Thursday, never.
Use those hands now.
It's Friday, I'm in love.
You should really feel it in the booty. When we're going side to side, you should be feeling it in the quads. Grab your sexy flexing. We're gonna hit some triceps here.
Eight. Let's go in a way.
Hands on the hip, elbow high.
Have a drink. Click, down the pipeline. Bad bitches like
switch it here. Four. Wrong band, Danny. The easy one.
Walk it out.
that heel. Oh yeah, we're feeling it. Yes, yes. Good job. Stay with me, Tammy. Oh! 4, 3, 2, kick it out. Stay low. Your hamstring. The area, which I call, I can't say what I call it. Between the booty and the legs. That raises it up. 3, 2, and 1. Good job. All right. We got your second flex. We got jumping jacks. Hands outside. If you're not jumping, you're tapping, or you're stepping. Turn right. 4, 3, 2, turn. Turn. Woo! Walk. Pull it back. Hands overhead, gaze. 4, 3, 2, turn. 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 Walk. JJ's. Turn. 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 Right here. Walk it back. A lot of chest facing me. Your chest should be facing the floor. Come on, use those arms as you can. Good job. I think Tammy was an Olympic skater. Yes, yes. Woo! Two steps, here we go. Again. One more time. Single count. Kick that leg behind. You got this, Tammy. You could stop with your arms, but stay low. Stay low, stay low. Push those arms as much as you can. Single step, heels out. Four, get that breath. We're gonna transition. You ready for squats? Here they come!
You know what I can do, stop it, the dogs are dropping. It's Friday night, so everything is popping.
Get down with me, get down!
So let the games begin. Yackety yack, don't talk back, go a song. Calling that girl on the car phone. Back 10, just got out of court, bowling through the
head. Another squat, four down, where are we? One, two, three, four, up, two, three, squeeze, down. Two, three, four, up, two, three, squeeze. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, up. One, two, three, up.
Oh, yeah. You think the hole in the air? If you don't care. Standing outside on a Friday, living on the edge. Cause we all got the hard heads. It seems like we all are waiting for the drive-by. Man, pack was
saying. Stay with me, you have 10 more. Take that deep breath. It's in. Hold. Exhale. Inhale, three, two, one, and hold. Two, three, four, exhale. Inhale. Inhale. Hold it right here. Reach those arms. High. Hold it with the right arm. Inhale. Three, two, one. Swing it out to the other side. Reach it up. Yeah. Whew. It's funny how when you start to really stop the panting, the water starts coming even more. Yeah, stay right here and hold. Deep inhale. Stretch that arm way overhead. I want you to feel like someone is pulling your arm. Pull it big, pull it big. We're gonna do a little rainbow. One more time, take a deep breath in. If you're feeling dizzy when you go down, don't go down. We're gonna go over to the side. Legs are straight, stretch it out. Open up that back, open up those hamstrings. Reverse. Inhale. Exhale up. Reverse. Inhaling. Exhale. One more time. Still that inhale. Now exhale. Stay up on the top. Hold it here. If this is too much for your back, go ahead and give yourself a little support. Small presses. Four, three, two, one. Inhale up. Reach it, reach it, reach it, reach it. Inhale, deep breath up. Over to the side. Small presses. Deep breath in. And exhale. Alright, one more time. Bring it on up. And we're going to stretch out those quads now. Great stretch for quads is just grabbing by the ankle. Bringing those knees to knee. Shoulders are even, hips are even. We can give a little extra stretch by reaching with the other hand. Shoulders are back, chest is lifted. Give me 2 more inches on that spine. Deep breath in. Give it a quick number 4 and sit. Arms come forward, inhale. Exhale. Come up, grab your other foot. Knees together, chest lifted high. Up through the diaphragm, your heart center is totally open. Your chest and your shoulders are completely back. Your abs are completely tucked, lifted into your diaphragm. Your chin is high. Your neck is relaxed. Notice the stretch in your leg. Pressing your hip even more forward. That's it. Alright, let's cross it into a number 4. Three, two, you stay there. You get 8 more counts. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And we have a message for today. A great message from a day book of positive thinking from the Blue Cards collection. And it's this. It says, don't dwell on your troubles. Don't dwell on your troubles. William James wrote, it is our attitude at the beginning of a difficult undertaking, which, more than anything else, will determine its successful outcome. Let me read that again. It is our attitude at the beginning of a difficult undertaking, which, more than anything else, will determine its successful outcome. Now, sometimes we don't go into things with a positive mindset. We get all harried in the confusion, the chaos, and the voices of ourselves and other people layering and layering. And we can't stop to think, so you have to pause. There's a power pause. When you stop to think, when you find that you have some bad news, something that's troubling you or that throws you off from what you were expecting or wanting or needing, there's always a silver lining. There always is a silver lining. So we have to first stop in the chaos and immediately gravitate to what that silver lining is going to be, what we can do in our part to make that for ourselves, our path involved in that situation. I won't name anybody's name, but somebody just got some news today that they were expecting somebody to come, and it's got to be disappointing. It's got to be, your hair looks good, by the way, Jamie. It's got to be, you know, hard when you get bad news, right? We get bad news. And we all get bad news. But if we stop in that bad news and we just go in the sad woe is me and the pity party and the how did that happen to me, or why is that happening to this person, and as a result, you know, you feel bad, or because of somebody else something happened to you. Instead of going into that thought, which is our first trigger, what can you do for your path to bring some roses and not thorns along the trail of this tribulation? What can you do to bring roses and not thorns? It's all in the positive mindset, 100%. So to not be triggered by something that someone else does or says, or that voice inside of you tells you is true. Because the truth is, we're all living a big dream anyway, so you might as well have it be pretty. You might as well have it be pretty. If you're having some noise amongst something, how can you, the first question isn't, how did this happen? Why did this happen? It's, what can I do to be better as a result of this? What can I do to be better as a result of this? That is positive mindset. That will take you to a different finish line and perceiving the whole journey completely differently. Yes or yes? It's the questions that we ask at the beginning, but hey, you know what? If we're involved in something right now and we didn't start at the beginning with a positive mindset, you can stop it right now and put on that positive mindset now. And the way to erase the negative is in a theta stance. So you are in theta either because you were put into a theta vibration, or before you go to sleep, right before you go to sleep, and right as soon as you wake up, you're in a theta wavelength. Your brain is in a theta wavelength. I guess our bodies are too, we just don't realize it. And so it is at that point that you can change the dynamics of how the mouse runs through the maze. Right? I say the mouse runs through the maze, I call that the thought pattern, right? We're used to going this way, then this way, then this way. Oh, we smell the cheese, right? But that cheese is sour and it's nasty. We don't want that cheese. We want to go a different way. So we have to get rid of the mouse. And the way to get rid of the mouse is in our thought process, and it is by writing and thinking. And it is as soon as you wake up and as soon as you go to sleep. I don't know about you, but sometimes I'm like exhausted when I go to sleep. Like I don't even remember hitting the pillow sometimes. I don't know if that happens to anybody else. But if you're that person, then this is perfect for you. Because if you put this on your nightstand, as soon as you go to sleep, as you're laying down, you read this, you chant it, you say it, you see it, you feel it, you breathe it. Your mind is going to be working on it while you go to sleep. It's the same thing for eating challenges. It's the same thing for anger challenges. It's the same. You can erase the patterns during theta. There's other ways to erase it. There's science-proven ways to erase it, but that is one of the ways. So I want to give you that. And without further ado, I'm going to let you guys go. Rock stars for dancing on a Friday night. I am. Yes. Get out your I love it, Tammy. I love when people bring their sticky notes to the table. Bring your sticky notes, you guys. Write down what you want. You know what? Sometimes the things that I find, or that find us, they're not pertinent to you. They're just not. But whatever is pertinent to you is what you still want to concentrate on. Where our mind goes, our actions flow. And where results come. Where our mind goes, our energies flow. Our actions flow, and there comes the results. Now they can either be positive or they can be negative. There's not anything else. You're either doing something really good for yourself or you're not. And it's okay to have chocolate chip cookies and strawberry dipped chocolate strawberries. It's awesome. And if you guys have a Trader Joe's by you, I want to invite you to these. They're chocolate dipped strawberries in the frozen department. They're small, they're awesome. They're guilt-free. And what I suggest you do is you put them into little baby Tupperwares or baggies That way you eat the baggie. Well, you don't eat the baggie. You eat what's in the baggie. Instead of eating the whole box like somebody else I know. Yeah, that would be me. Okay, you're not the only ones who might have a little struggle with food every now and then. I speak because I know. I just happen to have trained my metabolism to be friggin' ridiculous off the chart. And if you follow me through this 21-day journey, we're gonna start putting yours on it as well, okay? All right, you guys, create your best day ever. This is gonna be an amazing weekend. I am late getting you the 21-day. We just got some things figured out. I had some challenges with it, but it's better than it even was. And it's a little bit easier, a little bit less cumbersome. The book was friggin' 65 pages. I wrote a 65-page guidebook in 1 week. Nobody should do that. And nobody wants to read that. So I spent the last 3 days editing it down to like 30 pages. You're welcome. 30 good pages. And they have menu plans on them. So easy. I'd like you to try to follow the intermittent fasting for the 21 days. It's going to tell you exactly what to eat and when to eat it. Now, your window may be different than mine. You may be in a 12-hour window, an 8-hour window, or a 6-hour window. Whatever works for you and your schedule is perfect. So you don't have to follow mine, but what I'm suggesting you do is 2 meals a day and 1 or 2 snacks. There are days that I don't have any snacks. There are days that I find I have to have 3 snacks, but I eat snacks, and snacks are not coming in a package. They are either leftover from lunch, because I say to myself, I'm full, I feel comfortable, right? I want you to start really thinking about that. There's some rules in there. You guys follow rules? Yeah. I don't always follow my own rules so good. So I want you to try to follow them as much as possible. If you want to have some serious changes and feel differently after 21 days, you follow them as closely as possible without cursing yourself out for a bad day. Every day we're going to be noting if we're a 1, a 2, or a 3. A 1 is I rocked it. So you had the 2 meals plus the snacks. You drank all your water. You went to sleep on time. You had like a great day. You did some of the other self-caring things that I shared in there. A 2 is I could do better, right? So you had a little bit too much in something. 3 is kind of like I fucked up, but we don't say I fucked up. 3 is tomorrow's going to be a better day, but it's I fucked up, but not cursing at ourselves. It's like, okay, I fucked up. Tomorrow's going to be better. Sorry. Potty mouth. Anybody out there offended? I'm not sorry. I mean, I'm sorry. I crack myself up. So we're going to weigh in. We're going to be honest. You guys are going to be keeping track of it on our society page. Danny, I don't think... You're brand into the reset, so you're not a society girl yet. So you're going to keep track all by yourself. I don't know, maybe should we bring Danny into the society page during this 21 days? We're voting. We're going to bring her in, and anybody else who says that they're going to do it. If they don't do it, you're going to get locked out. So I'm going to let you know right now, I'm a little bit kind, and I'm a little bit, what's a good word for... Accountable. If you don't show up, you're going to get locked out. Normally I call people and I do a little babysitting. You might get 1 call from me. After that, if you don't show up for yourself, I'm not going to be meeting you halfway and trying to pull you in. Anybody, whoever it is. If you don't show up, you don't show up, and this may not be the right time for you. And that's okay, right? Like, it's not my time that's right for you. It's your time that's right for you. I didn't go plant-based overnight. It took me a long time, and nobody told me how long it was supposed to take me to get there. So I'm not here to tell you how long, but I'm here to say if you're ready, I got the tools for you, and this is how I do it with my personal clients. And my Biggest Loser did exactly what I have in this guidebook, and he lost 100 pounds in 5 months. There was no dieting and there was no deprivation. And I'll tell you why. People are like, that's bullshit. How do you not have deprivation if you're not having, you know, a whole pizza, or you're not having the snacks or the sodas or the things that you normally have? So deprivation comes when you're missing something.
Deprivation, if you look at like Webster's thing, I'm not going to go through the whole definition, but it's when you're being deprived. When you make a decision that you want something, you'll do anything to get there, yes or yes. You're no longer deprived. Mark deprived off the checklist. I don't want to hear, well, I can't do this, I can't do that, because the answer is no. You're not deprived because you want this. I'll show you how to add some stuff back in after, but you have to have 21 days solid. 21 days solid. Are we going to have some mess ups during the 21 days? A 1, 2, or 3? Yes. Are we going to show up no matter what? Yes. We're not going to judge ourselves. We're not going to feel judged. And we're not going to judge anybody else. We're going to support people who have threes. We're going to encourage them. We might even send them a personal message. It's okay. Don't cry over spilled milk. I don't do any crying in this set. There's no crying. You mess up, you mess up. You come back, you come stronger. It's okay. Deal or deal? Let's do it. You guys will be getting notifications within the next 24 hours to go grab it. So we'll be done by 4th of July so you can have some beers, okay? Bye. Have the best weekend.
You want to laugh?
Yes.
I'm still in.